expressed at what some observers feel is a tendency toward the militarization of space. What do you say to these concerns?
I think there are legitimate concerns about the militarization of space. We must be concerned in view of the fact that the Soviets have tested and now have operational an anti-satellite system, which could be interpreted as a quasi-violation of the 1967 treaty, which, as we all recall, provides that a nation's satellites in orbit are its national property and cannot be tampered with, and there is no other use for an anti-satellite system other than to tamper. So I think the conference has a right to be concerned about that kind of activity. However, the problem that we deal with in the issue is very broad definitions of militarization do reflect upon the very legitimate uses that nations make of space in order to do such things as military communications, navigation, and surveillance. And the surveillance systems that we use from space are the basis of arms control, and they are a stabilizing influence in the world in the sense that they provide political leaders with long lead times and being able to observe what's going on in other parts of the world. Since we are an open society in the United States and then behind the Iron Curtain, it is a closed society. They have ready access to what we are doing, but the only means we have of observing is through our space surveillance activities. And therefore, there is an asymmetry there which must be addressed when one addresses the military issue. So when you deal with the military issue, if you're dealing with just weapons, such as anti-satellite systems, you have one set of circumstances. When you are dealing with a broad issue, which says militarization is bad, then you are dealing with a whole host of issues which require very complex and very deliberate approaches so that you can address those asymmetries about which we must worry.
Do you see this as being a critical time in making decisions about whether space will be kept intact? I know Arthur C. Clarke has expressed concern, feeling that this may be our last chance to do this.
I think the current discussions which are going on here at the conference are very, very productive. We are dealing with many, many issues of technology and how we can join together in an international community of interest in order to exploit and continue our very beneficial and productive exploration of the last 25 years. That's far more important than, in my eyes, than the very, shall we say, explosive issue of militarization. The technology is moving very fast. We have the opportunity to do many things which have only recently become possible because of the very rapid movement of the electronics technology. I think it's important that the conference address the way in which international cooperation should proceed in order to gain those benefits worldwide. We have a great opportunity. I agree with Arthur there. We have a great opportunity to make use of the technology in the coming decade. And if we can form some good international basis of proceeding to that international cooperative exploitation and exploration, I think we'll do many great things in the future. I'm not worried that this is a watershed. It is an opportunity. I think the question of how we proceed is far more important than any specific issue at the present time.
Do you foresee increasing cooperation between the United States and the Soviet Union in space?
I think we have the potential of far more cooperation between the Soviet Union and the United States than we ever have before. The two programs seem to be going in complementary ways right now. The Soviets, for example, are exploring Venus. We, on our part, have explored Mars and are exploring the outer primordial planets beyond the asteroid belt. That's a complementary scientific effort. We exchange information, we exchange data, which means that our science and our ability to understand our solar system are vastly expanded by those complementary programs. They are operating a space station. We are operating a shuttle. There is the opportunity there to cooperate on a much more sophisticated and to a much greater extent than we've ever been able to do before. However, The problem that we have today is that that the Soviets have chosen a path of adventurism in Afghanistan and the problem in Poland, which makes cooperation from a political point of view difficult. The opportunity is there. If the Soviets will make some overtures to clear up the international tensions, then I think we can very, very easily cooperate and collaborate in the future.
Finally, can I ask you how you react to another suggestion that's been put forward by Arthur C. Clarke of what he calls the PeaceSat, a UN observer satellite to monitor various disarmament agreements? Do you think that this is a practical, useful, possible step for the future?
The idea of an international monitoring satellite is one that's been active for a number of years. The idea was first proposed, I think, some 4 or 5 years ago, when the Landsat or Earth Resources or satellites first came into operation, and it has great promise. However, I think the groundwork for that needs to be laid in the framework of an international cooperation rather than a UN activity. The UN has not been as an effective and a mechanism to operate operational kinds of systems. The operational space systems that are currently ongoing are things like Intelsat, the Inmarsat, the various activities wrapped around ocean surveillance and those other activities which have been international activities which have been in the UN framework but outside of the UN organization. If there is to be a peace sat, then I think it must be in that context, because the UN is not effective in operating systems where one needs to make decisions on a short-term basis, which is to say that in order to make such a system effective, you cannot be subject to the vote of one country out of a couple hundred. You must operate such a system on the basis of a very strictly defined operational group of countries which can decide what they're going to do with that system.
Mr. Biggs, thank you very much for talking with us.
Thank you.
Only a few seconds.
I know. Yeah. Sorry.